Hi everyone. I'm Yuvraj from Agri Career. Agri Career is a talent acquisition company specialized in recruitment for agri food and rural development industry. Today we'll be discussing what all has to be mentioned in a CV or a resume. Before going through the nitty-gritty, let me give a bullet point. The thumb rule says that if you are happy in any company, or if company is happy with you, or it's a win-win situation for a company and employee or an employer, you should not make your CV. I have not made my CV for first 7 years of my professional career or my first company. Second thing is that yes, if you want growth at much faster pace, or if you want a change, you want to learn more things, you want to change your sector, if you are getting an excellent opportunity, you can make your CV, which should be very much updated in fact, and it should cover everything in fact. So today we will be discussing what all things has to be mentioned in a good resume or a good CV. With me is my colleague Akanksha. Yes, please.
Hey guys, my name is Akanksha Sethi. This is my third YouTube video from Agri Career. So the first most important thing to be mentioned in your resume is your contact number. There should be two contact numbers in your resume. As a consultant, we face a lot of problems if the candidate does not mention their contact number in their resumes. If they mention their contact number, the contact number will be like out of coverage area, switched off, or out of service. The candidate should mention at least two numbers, either of their relatives or their friends who is in their contact, up to day-to-day contact, so that we can reach them. And the second most important is address. The candidate should mention their address in their resumes, so that we don't have any problem to send their current city location to the company. And the third most important thing to be mentioned in the CV is their qualification. Most of the people do not mention their qualification. The candidate should mention their qualification, highest qualification in their resume, so that we do not have any problem to send to the company. And they should mention the seminar attended and awards they have received so far. And if they have any experience in research and publication, if any, they can mention it. And the most important qualification as per their background should be in bold letters or highlighter.
Correct. Yes, Akanksha has mentioned some three important things, like two addresses should be mentioned in the CV, two phone numbers should be there, qualification should be there in fact, and it should be exhaustive in fact. Let me come to the fourth point in fact. Fourth point is CTC. In fact, we feel that whenever you are sending your CV, you should mention your current CTC in fact, either in the CV or in the body of the mail. It is always better if you can give a breakup of your CTC, if there is some variable, some incentives, some bonuses attached to your salary in fact. And if possible, if you can give your expected CTC, if you want a change, and if we can know, if we or any other company knows what is your expectation, if you can mention some of your expectation either in the percentage terms or either in the total CTC amount, it is excellent in fact. We as a consultant understand that whenever we will send your CV to any company, what salary hike or what CTC increment generally which company gives. So if we have this idea, what is your salary expectation, it's better for any consultant to place your CV in a better fashion. Yes, so CTC details are important thing which has to be mentioned in a CV. Yes.
And so the other important thing is that the CV should be in a Word format, not in PDF format. Some people send their resume in PDF format. It's, as a consultant, it is difficult for us to edit the CV and send to the company. So the candidate should send the CVs in Word format, as it is easy for us to edit the CVs and send to the company. And the last is optional, that either the photo or the references. The candidate who have photogenic face can paste their photo in the CV, or references the candidate can give two references. It is optional for them. It will be good if they give us their references and we can contact them and can send to the company, and if they need any job or a job change. Thank you.
Correct. Let me come to the next 2-3 important points. One of the next important thing to be mentioned in your CV is core competency. Everyone has some or the other core competency. Someone is good in business, someone is good in operations, someone is good in IT, someone is good in HR, someone is good in audit. So please try to mention your core competencies and strength. It can be either in a bullet form, or it can be a one word, or it can be a one line descriptive word. So mentioning your core competency makes it's very easy to understand your CV. So core competency is also one of the important points which has to be highlighted in a CV. Next is important point which has to be mentioned in your CV is your work experience. Generally, what should be ideally be done is you should mention your experience in months and years in some bold format, that you have such many years of work experience, these many years, these many months. So total experience is very important, and it is always better to mention all your last companies, previous companies, current companies, and try to have an exhaustive detail of your role and responsibilities in each and every organization which you have performed. So these details are very important to understand your CV. If you see any of the recruitment agency or any of the HR managers or any of the hiring managers, generally they screen and filter the CVs in less than 60 seconds, or it takes at the max it will take 2 or 3 minutes. So these are the some of the important things which we as a consultant or any of the company try to look for. So today we discussed something around 8 points which are important to be mentioned in your CV. Quickly let me summarize all the points in next few seconds. So today we discuss about some 8 things which has to be mentioned in our CV. We mentioned about there should be 2 contact numbers, there should be 2 addresses to understand that where you are based and where you have actually worked or what is your current location. We have discussed about the CTC. CTC should be given in a detailed format. We discuss about your core competencies, what all expertise you are having, it has to be highlighted in a bullet form. We discuss about the experience, We also discuss about 2 optional things, like if your photograph is very photogenic, you can paste your photograph, or elsewise also it is okay. The second optional thing was if you want to give references, it is good, or references will come at the later stages of the interview. So these are some 7-8 things which we discussed today. And we'll be coming up with more series for updating the CV, because CV is a very important document, and it's considered as an important document in the entire HR industry or HR business industry. So please try to have a good and updated CV. These are few were the tips from our side. Thank you. Have a great day. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.